Hello friends, today we're going to look at how to use shapes to create flowcharts in Microsoft Word. We'll also look at how to change the appearance of the flowchart's shapes and background. Lastly, we'll look at how to resize and reposition the flowchart's drawing canvas. We'll look at how to use smart art to create flowcharts in a separate tutorial. Today I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to the recent non-subscription versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for Mac, Word for the web, or Word for mobile. To begin, place your cursor in the document where you want to insert the flowchart. This can be an approximate placement because you can move it later on if necessary. Next, select the Insert tab, followed by Shapes in the Illustration group. Next, select New Drawing Canvas from the bottom of the Shapes menu. A drawing canvas will appear, and you should automatically move to the Shape Format tab. From there, select the bottom Shapes menu arrow in the Insert Shape group, and then choose a shape from the Flowchart section of the menu. Flowchart shapes represent particular functions. For example, rectangles stand for processes or actions, diamonds stand for decisions, and ovals stand for the beginning or end of a process or action. Therefore, you may want to do a bit of online research to see which of these shapes will be most appropriate for your flowchart. Next, click, hold, and drag the crosshair cursor to create the shape inside the drawing canvas. If it's not quite perfect, you can use the resizing handles to adjust the shape. You can also click, hold, and drag the shape to different locations within the canvas. Then, click inside the shape to add text. Repeat those steps to add more shapes as necessary. Once you have a few shapes on the canvas, return to the Shapes menu and select a connector from the Line section. And then click, hold, and drag the crosshair cursor from an anchor circle on one shape to an anchor circle on another shape to connect the shapes with the line. The circles will turn green when the shapes are anchored together. It's important to note that these connector lines only attach to the anchor circles when you're working inside a drawing canvas. Also note that you can drag the shapes into more precise positions without breaking the anchors. If you want to change the type of connector line that you chose, right-click it, and then select Connector Type from the shortcut menu, and then choose a new type from the drop-down menu. Before we move on, if you need to add additional text outside of the shapes, such as yes, no, or a title, select Draw Text Box, and then click, hold, and drag the crosshair cursor to add the text box. You can then type the extra text. With the text box still selected, you may also want to select Shape Outline and No Outline to remove the black outline that will appear around the text box by default. Now that we've added all of our shapes and connector lines, we're going to customize the flowchart's appearance. To begin, select an individual shape, or press and hold the Control key to select multiple shapes at once. You may notice that the resizing handles will appear when a shape is selected. You can now select the Shape Fill menu arrow and choose a color from the drop-down menu. You can also select the Shape Outline menu arrow and choose a color and an outline thickness from the Weight submenu. If you prefer something a bit more advanced, select Shape Effects to add additional options such as shadows, reflections, and beveled edges. Note that some of these options will alter your color and outline choices, so you may have to experiment to achieve the desired results. To change the appearance of the drawing canvas, first deselect all the shapes by clicking an empty area in the canvas. Then, click on the drawing canvas border. And then apply any of the options we just used on the shapes, such as changing the color. For more information about customizing shapes, please see my previous shapes tutorial, which will be linked below. To resize the drawing canvas, click, hold, and drag the handles. Alternatively, right-click the border of the canvas, and then select Fit to reduce the canvas to the size of the flowchart, or select Expand to extend the canvas to the left and right page margins. Today I'm going to use the handles for resizing. Next, select the Layout Options button and choose any of the wrap text options other than inline with text. Square or tight will be the best options for most projects. Finally, you can click, hold, and drag the drawing canvas to a new location in your document. With the flowchart in place, you can also right-click the canvas border and then select Insert Caption from the shortcut menu to add a figure caption. For a full tutorial, please see my previous figure caption and table title video, which will be linked below. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, where you'll find many related tutorials. Please feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to cover in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.